and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial we will learn how to plot the IV curve and the PV curve of our typical photovoltaic module under the full sun mode and under the partial shading condition. So in order to draw that, we need a photovoltaic module. I have used this photovoltaic module whose parameters can be set in this area. So with the V open circuit voltage equal to almost 60 degree, almost 58 voltage, and this is around 15 ampere current, and I have 36 series cells connected. Now I have given the temperature here, which is a standard 25 degree centigrade temperature with an irradiance of 1000 watt per meter square. So it is so we are going to plot the PV and the IV curve of this module under the standard testing conditions. Now for these things I have to measure the current as well as the voltage. Now in order to measure it, we have used a capacitance, which value I have written it to 1 millifarad. You can vary it according to your requirement. It is not a big problem. If you have a smaller capacitance, it will charge very fast. If you have a large capacitance, it will take some time. And also I have these things. We multiply the current and voltage to get the power which is stored in this thing. So for this we have to select this from the sync block parameter. We have to select these two workspace and we will give it some variable name. So let us call this variable as VPV, right? And we have to save this format as an array. We do not need to have structure with time or what. We need to save it as an array. So this is VPV and this is IPV. So because we need to plot both the IV and PV curve, therefore we need the current as well. And here is our PPV, which is our photovoltaic power. So we are going to plot it and let us see how it will plot. In the meanwhile, we have also used these displays that will show us when the current will be zero, we will stop this simulation. So let us start it. As you will see here, this value of current, it will come gradually to zero. You can see here. Okay, this is power, and you can see this is zero because of this current. So now I'm going to stop it, and now I have three things available here that I have measured, and this one is the default, which is the T out time. So first is the I photovoltaic current. If we plot it independently, you know, with respect to time, so this is our current I, which comes to zero because the capacitor, after it gets fully charged, it becomes an open circuit. And then we have the voltage. This voltage will be having this value because initially the capacitor was short circuited. So with the passage of time, it gets charged, so it attains the value of the open circuit voltage. And this one is the power, and this power, has you can see here, it goes high because of initially it was short circuited, so the power was zero, and finally it was open circuited, so the power was again zero. However, at a certain point we are getting the maximum power. So let us see how to plot it. So in order to plot it, I have written a simple code that defines, there are the x variable, which is the time in millisecond, the y variable in what, and blah blah blah. So here is my thing. I am going to plot the VPV, the power, with the voltage. So the x-axis come first, VPV come first, and PPV come second as a y variable. And then we have this VPV along with the IPV. So when I will plot it, let us see what will happen. So I have plotted this one. So this is our VPV curve, since we have not used the hold on condition, so it is showing me only the black curve, which is the PV curve. So you can see here, this PV curve is our maximum voltage, and this PV curve have one single maximum power point at this point. And also, if we want to have it, let us have the IPV curve, and this is our IPV curve. So now this is for the full sun condition. Now if we want to plot this for partial shading condition, we have to do a little bit of arrangements. So for this, we need to copy this one and okay, let me see what it is going on. Okay, just a minute. So let us copy this one and paste it here. Okay, I have a little bit of problem in my PC. It's okay now. And now we have these two available. And for the partial shading, our system has a single output, which will be our capacitor. However, we have different kind of irradiation, or we can have different kind of, although the temperature do not vary too much, so we will be having a 500 irradiance for this for the second module. Now we have to connect this module in parallel. So in order to have in series, I have to connect this negative with this positive, and this negative will go at this point. So the overall system will be such that we have the same capacitors as the load, and we will measure the cumulative voltage and the total amount of current that flows through it. But you will see, it depends on your model. If I simulate this one, it will give me an error, that we will see how we can solve it. But before that, we can rename it VPV underscore PS, that stands for the partial shading, and this IPV under the partial shading underscore PS, and this PV also under the partial shading, because it will otherwise it will rewrite those variables that are written on in this area, in this workspace. So if we simulate this one, you can see we are having an error that the photovoltaic module slash IPV block cannot be left open circuit because it is modeled as a current source. You should try to solve the circuit topology. So how to solve this problem? So in my case, I have solved this problem because it do not have it, since this is under the partial shading condition, so it must have some bypass diodes available. It do not have it. So what I will do is I will go to the sim library and eventually to the sim power system. In the power electronics, I will select this diode model here. I will put this diode here and I will just rotate it thrice. Okay, so let me rotate this one. Okay, rotate block, control R is clockwise. Okay, so now I have this one here. So I will put it here. Just a minute. Let me here as well as here. And the similar thing I will do for the other module. So for this module, now you will see that we will be having no error sign with this. So you see it is now working. Okay, so now we have another issue which states that the PV curve drawing module at this stopped at this time. There may be a singularity. No, this thing we can solve this thing. This is not a big issue. We can solve it by putting a small capacitor across it. Just a minute. Let me go to the series RLC load. I'm going to be here. Sorry, we need to series RLC branch is required. Series RLC branch is required. To get this series RLC branch, I'm selecting only a capacitor and a very very small value capacitor, 0.001. Okay, so I am going to rotate this one and I am going to place this across this value. Okay. And let us see if it works now. You see, without this error, you will not learn how you can simulate it accurately. Now it is working. See, it is working, and our IPV is gradually coming to zero. So now it is zero. So now you have to stop it. Now if I stop it and I go back to this value, I just need to change it with the new variable, which is, or alternatively, I can also have this VPV selected and then IPV selected. And if I plot it, I will get this type of curve. So this is the IV curve under the partial shedding condition. Similarly, I can write it here VPV underscore PS, and let us draw the PPV underscore PS, and if I now plot it, it will give me the, you can see here, it is giving me the partial shedding condition IV in the photovoltaic curve under the partial shedding condition. Now here we have an issue with the, we can get rid of all the other issues like bolding and other things. We can have a hold on condition to plot them simultaneously on the same graph, but that's up to you, and this is how we can simulate it. Thank you very much for this tutorial.